Yo, how's it going everyone? And in today's video, I'll be showing you every working glitch in GTA 5 Online in 2022. I want to start this video off by saying Happy New Year's. I hope all of you have a great year and is filled with joy and all your dreams coming true. This video will be a decently sized one, so strap in everybody. I took a lot of time researching and doing these glitches for you, so a like would be very appreciated, but it's never needed. Without rambling on any longer, here are some awesome glitches in GTA 5 Online. So for the first glitch of this video, I'm going to be showing you guys a very simple tan joggers glitch. You'll be able to get the tan joggers instead of GTA 5 Online, and you'll be able to keep it and save it as one of your outfits. So first, what you want to do is start up your CEO or join someone else's CEO, have them go to management or go to management, and select the Warlord outfit. As you can see, the Warlord outfit actually has the tan joggers on them, so that is going to help you out very much with this glitch. So first, after that, you want to go down to hide options, have your job set to custom so that the transform race separation spawns right here. Once you do that, just hop into the separation job, and then when you load in, just start up the race. Now that we're loaded in, what you're just going to do is just go to the right one and then just quit the race. You gotta be fast with this before your CEO outfit spawns. What you're gonna do is once you log in, you're just gonna go straight into the clothing store and spam right on the D-pad at the tops. And once you're loaded in, you're just gonna quickly run into the clothes store and start spamming right on the D-pad so that you get onto the tops. Just stay here until it should just kick you off, and then you'll actually load in with your CEO outfit. Just give it a second, it might take a little while. It depends sometimes, and there you go. As you can see, you now have the outfit, and you're not in your CEO. So, yeah, it's a very simple glitch, but it definitely works. That's how you get tan joggers. You can obviously customize the outfit as much as you want, like how you can change the shirt, and you can always change everything that you need with this outfit. And then, once you do that, you can just go over here, and you can save the outfit. So yeah, that is the first glitch in this video, and that is how to get your tan joggers in GTA 5 Online. For this next glitch, I'll be showing you guys how to get invisible ankles inside of GTA 5 Online. So now, the way to do this is to have any joggers on. The tan joggers glitch that I just showed you will work perfect for this. Basically, with the joggers, it glitches out and the boots and the pants don't fully connect, so that when you change the certain object in the clothing item, it makes the whole outfit bug out and then you have no ankles. So once you have your tan joggers on, head over to any clothing store and go over to the shoes. Once you have your shoes, simply just change the shoes. Some shoes don't work, but other shoes do. Just change the shoes and you have invisible ankles. Can't see them that good, but if you take off the shoes, you can definitely tell that there are invisible ankles over there. But yeah, really simple, and once again, you can obviously save this outfit as whatever you want, and that is how to get invisible ankles. So for this next glitch, I'm going to be showing guys how to get invisible arms. Basically, the first step is to just go into here and go to scuba suits. You're going to want to put on any scuba suit that you have in here. Me, personally, I'm going to use the black scuba suit, but you can obviously use whichever scuba suit you want, as any scuba suit works. You're going to go ahead and save the scuba suit to whichever slot that you want. I'm going to personally save mine under the tan joggers, and I'm just going to call it scuba. Actually, no, I'm not going to do that because I already have a scuba outfit, but I already have a scuba outfit saved, so I'm just going to use that outfit. And once you save the outfit, we're going to show you guys what to do right next. Now, once you have that saved, you're going to go into outfits, and then you're going to go to bodysuits. You can choose any one of the bodysuits. Personally, I'm going to just choose the orange wireframe bodysuit. So make your way over to the pier, and then once you're at the pier, you're going to actually go onto any telescope. I think I actually passed it. So go to the pier, and then you're going to do the telescope glitch. If you don't know how to do the telescope glitch, you just have to run past the actual telescope, and then when you run past the telescope, just spam right on the D-pad. I messed up, but let me try that one more time. So just run past it, and when you're running past, just spam right on the D-pad. And then there we go, I did it. So when you do that, you're just going to go into style, and then you're going to go over to that scuba suit outfit that you just got saved. Let me find it. And then you're going to actually do that. When you walk away, you should see that the bodysuit has merged onto the scuba suit like you see right here. Once you do that, you're just going to fly, drive, or do whatever, and just make your way right down the road into the actual match store. So once you're here, just head over to the vests. And when you get here, you're going to want to head over and do the ones that I'm showing you right here. You want to get these styles of vests. I'm personally just going to do the yellow one since I already have it. Once you do that, you're just going to go ahead and get over to the river, or not the river, the ocean. Once you're in the ocean, you'll see that the scuba suit will actually be on your character once you fully run in and you go underwater. So I'm going to go ahead and do that right now. So now that you're in the water, you're just going to run and until the scuba suit actually appears on your character. That's how you know you did it right, if the scuba suit appears. After that, just kill yourself and take the easy way out. And when you spawn, you should actually see that you have the invisible arms. And that is it for this glitch. This is how to get invisible arms. You can save this outfit and do whatever you like. And yeah, it's a pretty cool glitch. So for this next glitch, I'm going to show you guys how to stand underwater. So take any vehicle of your choosing and throw a sticky bomb or just blow it up in any way. Once it blows up and the parts actually go flying everywhere, you're going to find a door, a hood, anything like that that you can stand on. A door would probably work the best, but I don't actually see where the doors went. But it's basically anything that you can stand on. So like something like this wouldn't actually work. I'm actually going to use this police vehicle as an example because them doors didn't really fall off. So just head over here, blow up the vehicle, either use the doors or use the hood once it falls off. Just shoot each thing, shoot it to the water. What you're going to do for this glitch is you're just going to get it into the water, and once it gets in the water, you're going to actually stand on it so that you and it will take off together. You gotta use some nice timing for this. I'm about to die to the cops, bro. And then just keep shooting it until it goes off. I won't go, I'm about to die to the cops, bro. But that's basically the glitch. You just shoot the door into the water, and right as it gets into the water, you stand on the door, and the door will actually fall into the water, and you'll be able to stand underwater. So for this next glitch, I'm going to show you guys how to color your BMX bike color. So normally, you can't put color on a BMX bike, which is, like, really stupid. Rockstar should definitely add that. So this guide is going to show you guys how to add a custom BMX bike color. So open up the internet app in your in-game phone and head over to the website Pedal to the Metal, or Pedal and Metal, whatever. Once you're there, select a BMX bike. Do not hit order. On the top of the page, select the home button that takes you to the iFind home page. Once you're there, go to Legendary Motorsport and scroll down until you find the Trophade Z-Type. Your best bet would to like sort by price and then keep going up, because I believe it's 900,000 or it's very close to around there, and you're probably gonna find it through there. Let's just see. There it is, Trophade Z-Type. Click on the Z-Type and select the color you want your BMX bike to be. Don't order the Z-Type because you're gonna waste a ton of money. So whatever color you want the BMX bike to be, just put it as that color. So let's say I just want a pink BMX bike. I do that. Once you pick the color, look at the top of the page. There's a history button. It'll be this thing. Click on it and bring down a drop box of the recent websites. Find the bike details tab and click on it. You should be back at the BMX bike page. At this time, hit order and purchase the bike. Once you purchase the bike and put it to any garage, you'll actually have the colored BMX bike. You'll be able to ride the BMX bike around, and it'll have that specific color instead of just the classic gray. So this is definitely one of the better glitches. I just really wish Rockstar would actually add it into the game. I feel like it would be a nice feature, but you know. So this next glitch will show you guys how to skip the taser cooldown and have infinite fire on the taser. So first, what you want to do for this glitch is have the custom weapon locker. Once you have the custom weapon locker, whether it be in your CEO, bunker, whatever it is in, you're going to have the taser set to disabled, or where it's not in your custom weapon wheel. Once there, go to inventory, and it will say enable and disable custom loadout. If you enable the loadout, you'll see that you have your actual taser. Where'd it go? Actually, the wrong disable custom loadout will have your taser. So for this, just go up to any of your victims and just tase them. Once you tase them, pull up your interaction menu, go to inventory, and click enable and then disable again, and it will remove and then add the stun gun again, which basically triggers the game to give you no cooldown. So we're gonna try it on this girl right here. She's on the phone, so I'm just gonna shoot her. Then you see that there's a cooldown in the top. I'm gonna enable and then disable and then go back and get the stun gun, and there's absolutely no cooldown at all. You can do this before your opponent gets up, so do this for good, not bad. Don't just go around doing this to random people unless they did something to you or someone you know, obviously, because that's just annoying. But yeah, that is how to skip a taser cooldown in GTA 5. So now this next glitch will show you how to get a colored weapon wheel. You can either choose between the colors pink or a yellowish, and all you need for this is to have a friend that is playing GTA 5 online. They don't have to be a friend that you really know, just have someone that will be able to have joined, so you can just join them through your friends list or just through the GTA Online menu very easily. For this video, as an example, I'm going to be using the pink stunt series. To get the pink, you're just going to want to join the job. When the lobby loads up, quickly find a friend that's playing GTA and join their session. For this next glitch, I'm going to be showing you guys a helmet and mask merge glitch. This can be used to make some awesome modded outfits, so let's get straight into it. My character is bugging out, y'all see this? Bro, he looks like a Roblox. What? What? Okay, so I'll show you guys the glitch. So basically just run past the telescope and do the telescope glitch. Once you do that, First, you're going to want to put on a mask or a helmet of your choosing. Should have stated that first, I forgot. So let's use this white knit balaclava. I don't know how to pronounce it, whatever. You're gonna put on the mask first, or the helmet first, and then you're gonna do the telescope glitch. You're gonna go to style, go to accessories, and you're gonna put on whatever mask, hat, helmet, whatever you want. But this especially looks good with masks and bulletproof helmets. And as you guys can see right here, the mask and helmet actually merge onto each other, and you can create some awesome outfits with this. I still don't understand why Rockstar didn't add this normally, because, like, it's such a simple thing to do. Like, you should be able to put bulletproof helmets on a ski mask or a gas mask or stuff like that, because in real life you can, so why can't we do it in GTA 5? Who knows? But that is this glitch, and let's move on to the next one. Alright, so this is going to show you guys how to get colored bulletproof helmets. Not exactly bulletproof, but they're more of combat helmets. So basically, head over to a clothing store, go to somewhere where they sell hats. Once you're in here, you're going to go over to where the helmets are, the combat helmets. You're going to scroll down to either 24, the zebra quad lens, or number 46. Each one are different because number 24 has the quad lens and number 46 has the dual lens. I'm going to go with the dual lens because I already have it. So back out, open interaction menu, go to the style, and set the visor up. So now once you do that, you're going to want to just save the helmet in any slot. Head over here and just save it. I'm just going to call it helmets. Once you have the helmet saved, I'm going to tell you guys exactly what to do with the corresponding colors, because you have to know the colors so that you know which you are buying. So basically, head back into the helmets, and when you head into helmets, you're gonna want to go into the basic normal. I believe they're just biker helmets. Helmets. I don't know why I thought they were normal. So you're gonna go down until you find the Cernd helmets. So keep scrolling down, keep scrolling. It's a little while. Jeez. Okay, so once you're here, these are the colors that correspond with each other. The orange helmet will equal the black helmet. The green helmet will equal the gray helmet. The purple helmet will equal the open face helmet. The pink will equal the white open face helmet. So I'm gonna go ahead for this video, just do the orange so that it's just easier because I already have it. You're gonna want to register as a CEO. Get into any car, and when the engine begins running, actually before that, you're gonna go to style and set the bike helmet to the helmet that you just had on, and then get into the vehicle. So get in the vehicle after you set the bike helmet as an orange helmet or whatever helmet it is for you. Once the engine starts, go to style, CEO, management, style, and then just change it one to the left or one to the right, and then one to the left. Back out and exit the car. Just right on D-pad on the visor down. So go over here to accessories. And where's it at? No, since yeah, style, accessories. No, it's not. Where's it at? Where's the visor? Okay, there it is. So then you're gonna do visor down, and the color should change into what you just had it. So yes, I was correct. That is what it is, because the orange will change into the black. So now I have a black helmet. So that is how you do the colored helmets, and you can make some really cool outfits with these helmets, and that is it for this. This next glitch will show you guys how to get a ripped t-shirt in GT5. Head over to Tops, go to t-shirts, scroll down to the t-shirts, where they at? Right here. Once you're in t-shirts, get any of the normal size t-shirts, like this one. If you have anything like a jacket on, make sure you take that off. You're gonna go down to the utility vests, and you are going to equip the peach plate carrier. So scroll down, I believe it's number 43, if I'm correct. Nope, it is number 39. Oh wait, no. No, it is 43, my bad. It's 43. And then after that, you're going to save the outfit in slot 1. Once you do that, save the outfit in slot 1. You're going to go over to the front outfits, and you're going to go to the heist coveralls. Once you're in heist coveralls, get any of the bottom 4 gas mask suits. I have the scientist because I already own it. Once you have that, go to the pier and make sure that you don't have any accessories on your outfit. Once you get to the pier, do the telescope glitch by running across the telescope and have your character just standing there. Once you're there, equip the save outfit that you just saved. That should be called something like 1. After that, make your way over to the mask shop. Once you make it over to the mask shop, just go into the Tops and overwrite the saved outfit by saving it again. Once you save it again, start up a Titan of a job by going to jobs, play job, works are created, missions, and it'll be the first mission available. Once you spawn into a Titan of a job, head over to the ammunitions. Once you go into ammunitions, run over into the outfits, and just one more time, save the outfit. Once you do that, just quit the job. Once you load into GTA Online, run into the ammunition, and go to the outfits. Once you get to the outfits, go to the outfits and click on the standard, and you're going to get number 3, the effortless. Once you get the effortless, you're just going to want to take off the glasses. Go back to any clothing store on the map. Go to tops once again. Go down to vests. And then once you're on vests, you're going to equip any of the bottom ones that look like this. Once you do that, you're going to start up any heist finale. My preferred one will probably be Fleek of Heist, since you only have to do one setup. Once you go into the heist finale, you're going to launch it, set the clothing to player, and invite someone. Once you join it, you're just going to load in and quit. Get into any personal vehicle, make sure you are saved as a CEO, and then once you are saved as a CEO, go into the outfits, go over one, and then go back over one. Once you get out, you will see the ripped shirt. This next glitch that I'm going to show you is how to save CEO outfits. So once again, set yourself as a CEO, go to management, go to style, and choose any outfit that you want to have. Firstly, my favorites are El Jefe. Have your hide options set to show all and join the transform race separation and be at this exact clothing store. Once you get in here, just go over one and then leave it. This one is very similar to the actual tan joggers glitch, but it's a little different in certain types of ways. Once you load in, quickly run into the store and just keep spamming on the D-pad. Once you get into here, it'll start kicking you out, and once you get kicked out, you'll see that you have the outfit just like you do the tan joggers in the other glitch that I showed you. So you got kicked out, just leave the CEO and you'll see that you still have the outfit. Just go over here and you can save the outfit. You can also customize it. I don't think you can customize the actual outfit, but you can add accessories like change the hats, you can add chains, you can do everything. It's a pretty cool outfit and it's a pretty cool glitch. So this next glitch that I'm going to show you guys will be an LS Customs Car Meet Wall Breach. Open up the door with your vehicle but do not go in. You want to have it pretty close but not too close where it doesn't trigger the animation. You just want to have it to where it keeps the actual door open. Shoot the guy in there so that he doesn't mess with you, and pull out your up and atomizer. Head over to about, I'd say, here, and you're just going to up and atomizer yourself up into here. Sometimes when you're uphill, it'll work, sometimes it doesn't work, but we got it first try. You're actually under the map, and if you're going first person, you can see a little bit better. You can see all the way around the map, so it's pretty cool. This is how you can do a wall breach into the Los Angeles Customs. You can shoot all on the floor, and I believe you can actually shoot. No, you cannot, but there's one certain section of it that you can shoot out of. I don't remember which one that is, but you can shoot out of some sections. So it's a pretty cool glitch because you can actually see around parts that you normally don't get to see. Like, you would not be able to see up here at this roof normally, but since this glitch is around, you actually can. The only ways to get off are by dying or just simply jumping off. For this glitch, you're going to need a Vito Classic go-kart. The location for this glitch will be right behind the barbershop and in between the clothing store in this back alley. This will be a wall breach to get into this wall over here. You're going to take your Vito Classic go-kart and you're going to bring it up this little staircase type of place. It's like the handicap type of walkway. And once you're here, you're going to just drive it right in through here. Have it park, get out, get back in, and then just drive. And then you're right here, and you're stuck into this wall. You don't have very much room to go around in, but it's a pretty nice wall breach. If you want out, you can always just drive out, and then you can just drive right back in. It's one of the first wall breaches that I've really done, because I don't do them too much. And it's a really nice one, as well as the Los Santos Customs. As a Vito Classic, it's just really fun to drive, and I think the wall breach is definitely a very fun glitch to do. This next glitch will show you guys how to get the flight suit air vent under any outfit that you want. Select any outfit that you want and put on the actual gas mask that you want. I don't know why I just went to gear, but it should just be under masks, and you should just be able to put the gas mask on. So once you actually have the gas mask on, you're just going to head into the building. Let me find it. I don't know where it's at. I don't know why it's taking so long to find it either. Oh, there it is. Alright. Oh, gas mask, yes. So head into here and make sure that you have your outfit. I recommend saving your actual outfit just in case. Once you have your outfit saved, just head down to the flight suits. Get a flight suit that you already have, it really doesn't matter. The front part of it won't save, just the tube. Head on over across the street to the high heel. Once you go into the high heel and you just walk in, you'll actually notice that the stuff goes away. So let me show you that real quick. Let me just walk up or drive my little go-kart into the high heel, and then once we get here, you're simply just going to want to walk in.
Come on in. Have fun.
Once you walk in, you'll see that it's gone, so go back in and select that outfit, and then walk back out, and you'll see that the tube is on it, and personally, I think it looks absolutely sick. I think it's one of the coolest glitches, and this has been around since, like, the last gen days, and it still works, which is pretty cool. So yeah, that is going to be how to get the flight tube onto your outfit. So this next glitch is going to be very simple and very easy to do. This will be how to stop your vehicle immediately. So go as fast as you want, pull up any character, and just bring it to the screen where it says this. Are you sure you want to quit this session? Progress will be automatically saved. Once it says that, just press circle and then your car will automatically stop. So let me do another example. Let me go as fast as I possibly can. Pull up your selection menu, do it, and then just press circle and your car will instantly stop. So this next glitch will show you guys actually how to get inside of Franklin's house. As you guys know, they made some changes to his property by adding some new vehicles with Franklin. So this is how you get into his house. Climb up onto his house and get around this back part. Once you're here, get up around this panel right here and get around this part right here and just up and atomize yourself. You don't get it every single time, but every now and then you'll actually end up getting it. I'm gonna get some snacks real quick because I'm about to die from doing all this. Thankfully for New Year's, they redid my snacks. So you're just gonna wanna come back just a little bit and just time it greatly and slide right into his house, and voila, you're right into Franklin's house. You can walk around, you can do everything that you want. The entire house is available, except for that one room that you're not allowed to enter in story mode. You can't enter that one either. Yeah, you can enter his bedroom, and you can do everything that you would normally be able to do in story mode inside of online. So this is another pretty cool glitch. So the last and final glitch of today's video will be how to add a pearlescent into the matte color. This is going to be a very simple glitch that you can do to get the pearlescence under the matte colors. This can only be done at the Los Angeles Customs, so just know that. Once you get into the Los Angeles Customs, just head over to the respray options and go to primary color and go to matte. You can get any of the matte colors or matte, however you want to say it, and you can get the black. I just like the black because this is a Jeep. You just get any colors. Go into metallic, look through the colors, just keep hovering over the metallic colors for at least 10 seconds or until you get to about like 40. Quickly back out of the metallic section and put your crew color on and then off. So real quick, just scroll for about 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And back off and then quickly put your crew emblem on and then take it back off. If you did this correctly, you can enter the pearlescent section with the matte A color, which is a really cool glitch, and you can make a lot of really cool colors with this, like black and yellow. This is a really nice one, and you can do a lot of really cool color combinations that you normally can't do. I really just want to know like why we can't normally do this. Like, this would look so awesome to just be able to do on any vehicle that you want. The matte colors with the pearlescent would make outfits look way nicer, especially with like certain color combinations that you can't naturally do. So this video showed every single working glitch in GTA 5 Online. If this was helpful in any way, smash the like button down below and subscribe with notifications on, as this video took a really long time. If you want to see more of me, make sure that you guys check out my most recent videos so that you guys can stay up to date with the most recent glitches, guides, and tutorials for the world of GTA 5 Online. Without further ado, have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you all later. Peace.